Is the follicular unit extraction hair transplant method an option for men of African descent? If so, where? I'm a male of African descent, 37 years of age and approximately stage 3 to 4 on the Norwood scale. I live in Ontario, Canada. I'm told I would require 2,000 to 2,500 grafts to bring about adequate coverage from hairline to the crown area. But the robotic or test and neograph methods would not work due to the type of hair I have, and the strip method is the only option. I wear my hair low and would prefer not to bear the resulting scars from the type of procedure.
Thank you for your question. You're 37 years old and you describe yourself as being a Norwood 3 to 4, and you have gone for consultations. You're asking about whether or not FUE would be right for you, and that you were advised that these different robotic and other technologically based methods of hair transplant were not right for you. So this is an opportunity for you to understand a little bit about the hair transplant concept, and based on also your preference of the way you have your hair cut and how it factors in to a decision-making process. I'll also introduce you to something that you've probably not heard of that might change your decision altogether. So let's start with just understanding what a hair transplant is. A hair transplant is basically accepting that hair will continue to thin, and that what we try to do is improve the overall framing of the face by transplanting hair from a narrow area behind the scalp called the genetically resistant hairs or permanent zone to the front of the scalp. And when we do that, there are two different techniques. One is called a FUE, and that includes the robotic method as well as the handheld vacuum method, as well as just manually making little punches and taking out the individual hairs. Then there's the FUT or strip method, and that's been the traditional method for many years, where a thin strip of skin is removed with hairs and individual hair grafts are cut. Debating which is better and worse can go on for hours at any conference, but what is a challenge for you is the length of hair and the type of hair you have. I'm going to introduce to you an alternative that is something that we would offer to you if you were to come to our practice, or someone like you would come to our practice about what to do about your progressive hair loss. At 37, you've advanced significantly, and it's clear that the bridge or the middle of your scalp is thinning, and that you can assume that reasonably that within a few years, that area is going to be too thin and it'll be probably gone, and that you would need additional transplantation. Where we've developed a method called hair regeneration, where when someone like you comes to our practice and talks about doing a hair transplant, we actually teach them about hair regeneration, which is a combination of a wound healing technology called extracellular matrix combined with platelet-rich plasma derived from your own blood. What we are doing is we're doing an injection and not a transplant. By doing this, we have been able to reverse the hair thinning process and thicken up the existing hairs, as well as literally wake up a lot of the dormant hairs, the hairs that were on skin that was relatively smooth and have remarkable growth. Now, this is something completely different from traditional methods of medical treatment, which include finasteride and minoxidil. But rather, it is basically using your body's own adult stem cells that are naturally occurring, and that we believe, based on clinical response, is restoring the engine and protecting the hairs from being thinned, because most of our patients who are males don't take Propecia. And so we've been able to do this injection, and we have 3 to 5 years of data showing that people don't need additional treatment. Of course, in our practice, we are always ready to retreat anyone. But I think that this would be my choice for you, given the limitations, because with a transplant, you're looking at a single procedure, but you are also looking at an ongoing progression of thinning. And the negatives of an FUE is that no matter who does it, it has been my observation that people are getting hairs outside of the zone of permanence, such that essentially the hairs they're moving are actually going to eventually thin. So we kind of we refer to that as basically it's a rental, because it's moving, it's being moved, but it's not going to grow for longer than a certain period because it's naturally going to thin. This is unfortunately a reality with a lot of FUEs, because especially in African Americans, where the curliness of the hair is great for coverage, but the density of hair in the donor area is usually significantly less than Caucasians or Asians. So you have to go wider to get a lot more grafts. Now, a strip method we can do, but the problem is that there can be some stretch in the skin. And when you wear your hair so short, that scar can be seen. So my strategy would be for you would be to do hair regeneration first, try to save the hairs, thicken up what you've got, and then maybe, if you still want more, do a limited transplant approximately a year to almost, you know, 15 months, 18 months later to help you get what you want with as little surgery as possible. And very often I would talk someone like you out of surgery altogether, because, you know, you want to invest your resources and get the results in a very intelligent way. So I think my conclusion would be as a recommendation for hair regeneration. And so you can start doing some research, look for a provider in an area that's convenient for you, and consider that before moving forward with the surgical procedure. I know this is a lot to think of. I've probably sent you off on a different tangent, but like I said, we have been very successful with this, treating patients who come to us from all over the world. And I thought it just felt very compelled to share with you what we would do in for people who like yourself who would come to our practice. I hope that was helpful, and thank you for your question.